Hello everyone, welcome to Reach Goals. Today I'm going to talk about logging in distributed systems. There are a lot of questions surrounding it, and let's see one by one, right? So the first question is, we are going to talk about how to log errors in the distributed system, and I'm going to talk about two different ways. The other one is how to count the specific error and generate the reports. For example, if you want to know how many are 401 errors, or how many errors are happened due to the order calculation, or how many of the errors are due to the tax calculation, etc. Right? Also, finally, I'm going to talk about three real production issues and the solutions. So let's talk about logging in the distributed system. So normally, if you look into the distributed system, you have a number of clients across the globe, and they will connect to the load balancers, and the load balancer in turn connects to the multiple nodes which are situated across the globe, right? So something what you see on the screen. So if you look over here, all the logs will be accumulated into the respective machines, right? So now if I want to get certain information from the log, it's very difficult for me to go into each and every node and figure out what actually the log or what actually the log error messages has. So now the right way for me is I have to take all these log files or the log messages and send it across to a centralized location. So how do you do that? You will be having something called as an agent at each and every node, and they in turn, it takes all these log messages and it sends to the centralized location. So the centralized location is nothing but it is a server or a cluster which is made of log stash, right? So finally, in the log stash, I can connect to the Elastic server or Elastic Search, right? From there, what I can do is I can use the visualization tools like Kibana, and they can start searching the files which is already there in the log stash, and I can use it to index that, right? So once the files are indexed, I can get the right information from the logs. That is the type one or the way which is commonly used across the industry, right? Now, if I want to look into the type two or the different way to do that, what I can do is, instead of having the file generated and sending across to the centralized location directly, I can have a Kafka queue or Rabbit queue connecting from the logs, and I can subscribe to that, and I can send all the messages to the log stash, right? Or I can subscribe directly to get some relevant log messages. For example, as I talk, if I want to get the 401 error, or if I want to count number of errors happening in the order calculation, then what I can do is I can specifically subscribe to those messages, and I can get those information and create a report out of that, right? So there are totally two ways. One is directly connecting from the machines and having it at the centralized location, that's type one. And the second one is you can have a queue, and from that queue you can pass it to the log stash, and you can do the similar mechanism to have a Elastic Search, and you can use the Kibana tool to visualize that, right? So if you look into what is the best option, whether to go in the type one or the type two, I would say the type two is the right one, because if you have multiple servers and let's say one server goes down, what happens is you will not be able to see the files or the logs generated from that server, which is transferred to the centralized log. Let's say if you have a queue, it's very easy for you to scale it and scale up. Based on that information or based on that mechanism, you can get the logs into the queue, and it can finally transfer into the log stash, right? So if you have a traffic consuming system where if you want to scale it up or scale it down, I would prefer to go with the mechanism where you involve a queue in between to get the log informations, right? So the next thing I want to talk about is how to have a right log, or how to have the enough information in the log for you to get searched, right? I'm going to talk about five different points over here. Let's do one by one, right? So let's say if you want to send a log message, the log message should have the correlation ID. Correlation ID is nothing but it's a unique ID which goes from the client location and it traverses across the end location, where if you want to get any information related to the log, you can use the correlation ID to search that and get it, right? The second one is response. A response should have a unique ID. Unique ID is nothing but it is the same as a correlation ID. Let's say if you want to get some information related to an error, and if you have the correlation ID and you can clearly track where the request came from and how it got generated and where the error was coming up, and finally how it shows up in your response, right? And the third one is standard log format. It'll have a standardized service. So let's say you have multiple services in a distributed system, right? Each and every service will be generating its own log formats. Now, if you have a different formats, it's very difficult to index and search it. So that's why I prefer to have a standard service. In the standard service, what you can do is you can convert or you can have a wrapper kind of thing to transfer all the log information, and can have a unique mechanism to create a standard log structure, and it can be sent into the centralized log server, right? So the next one is the request context. The request context is nothing but it should have all the information related to the date, time, stack errors, and service name, and also you should have an IP address and HTTP code, etc. If you have this context, it is easy to figure out what message you're looking for and what information you are trying to extract from the logs, right? And it is also easy to do indexing of the log files. And the final one is logs should be searchable. As I said in the previous one, if you have all this information and if you have a key value pair of kind, it is very easy for you to search and get the relevant information, right? So let's talk about the real production issues and how to solve that. The first one is the PII issues, right? So if you look at what PII is, it's a personally identifiable information, right? So in the logs, if you have informations like the email ID or your name or your address, then those are all called as the PII information. So if you're creating a log information, you have to make sure you should not have those informations, right? That is a security constraint. The second one is storing the sensitive information in the logs. I would say you should not even store any sensitive information in the logs. For example, the sensitive information could be your password or the social security number or any other information which are related to the user can be sensitive information, right? So if you have those information, it is a huge security risk. And the other one is, this is a performance thing, right? Excess logs impacts performance. So you have to be very clear what kind of messages you are storing in the logs, right? So as I said, if you have a lot of log messages generated from your application or from your services, it's going to create a extra call to the backend where it gets to a lot of log informations or log messages. So that's really a performance impact for your overall application, right? So you have to be very clear whenever you do any log messages, or when you add something extra to the log, you have to undergo the performance testing to make sure we are meeting all the standards and SLAs, right? Thanks for watching.